Tirmizi reported on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, Allah ta'ala loves for the sign of his grace, ni'mat, to be visible on his servant. Imam Ahmad al-Nasai have reported from Abu al-Ahwas, and he in turn reported from his father. He says, I presented myself before Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and my clothes were frail. Huzur sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Do you not have any riches? I replied by saying that I did. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, What type of riches do you possess? I replied, I have all types of wealth given to me by Allah. I have camels, cows, goats, horses and slaves. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah has blessed you with riches, so the sign of his grace and his marvels should be visible on you. In Sahih Bukhari, it is reported from Hazrat Umar, Anas, Ibn Zubair and Abu Umama radiallahu ta'ala anhum that Nabi Kareem sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, One who wears silk in this world will not wear it in the hereafter. In Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, on the authority of Ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, For the one who wears silk in this world, there is no share in the hereafter. In Sahih Bukhari and Muslim, it is reported from Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam forbade the wearing of silk except for this much. And Rasulullah indicated this by bringing his two fingers together. The kalima means the index finger and the middle finger. It has been mentioned in one narration of Sahih Muslim that Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said during a khutbah, means a sermon, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade the wearing of silk except for that which is equal to the span of two or three or four fingers. In other words, a silk edging of that width can be used on any clothing. In Sahih Muslim, on the authority of Asma bint Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, that she brought out a kasrwani jubba, the collar of which was made from dibaj, a type of silk, and there were silk edgings on both slits. She said, This is the robe of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, which was in the possession of Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And when Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha passed away, I took it into my possession. Huzur sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to wear it, and we rinse it and give its water to those who are ill, so that they may attain shifa. Tirmizi and Nasai have reported from Abu Musa Ash'ari radiallahu ta'ala anhu that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Gold and silk are halal, lawful for the women of my ummah, and haram, unlawful or forbidden upon the men. In Sahih Muslim, it is reported on the authority of Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, who says, Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam saw me wearing clothing which was dyed in safflower, it's a colored dye. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, This is the clothing of the unbelievers. You should not wear them. I asked, Should I wash it out? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that I should burn them.